You go.
So right. It is Friday, essentially, for us. And it's not even Friday night.
It's Thursday night.
It's Thursday night, but it's Friday night for us. This is LoveLine. I'm Adam Carolla. That is Dr. Drew. He's a board-certified physician and addiction medicine specialist, and the phone number is 1-800-LOVE-191, 1-800-568-3191. Faxes 310-854-4455. We have a full plate tonight, Doc.
Mm-hmm.
Because coming in here in about 8 minutes, we have the lovely Pamela Gidley. And she claims she has some pox or something tonight.
Right,
what does
right.
she have?
She has zoster.
Zoster?
Shingles.
Chicken pox?
Shingles. It's related to chicken pox. Yeah.
Well, I was asked if I had chicken pox.
Right.
If I had chicken pox, can I not get zoster?
That's not true.
So I'm a prime candidate for zoster. I could have a zostic weekend.
You could have, yeah, you could have a weekend opox. Yes, you could.
I think I rented that. Yeah, so she'll be in a second. Yeah. Now, she's from Strange Luck, which is Friday nights at 8 o'clock on the Fox Network with D.B. Sweeney. She plays his on-again, off-again girlfriend reporter type. She's also, if you take a look at TV Guide, and I never do, but I do like to look at the people on the cover, she's in there for the top faces of 96. And I don't think it's one of these things where they pick 12 or 13,000 people. I think they narrow it to just like a handful.
Right.
So it's a pretty tough list to make. You ready to go to the phone, Stop?
Sure, let's do it.
Oh, we also have Hagfish coming in at 11:30, but we'll get more into
buckle
that
in
later.
For that,
yeah,
boy.
Buckle up and put on your slickers. Brian.
Yeah, hey, Adam, Drew.
Hey, you're on LoveLine.
Yeah, I was wondering why porn is legal and prostitution isn't.
Porn isn't legal in a lot of states.
Is that right?
Yeah, that is right. And there's certain rules about pornography, like actually making it. I don't know. Someone's going to call us and someone's going to correct us. And you think that I would be well schooled in this, but I'm so involved with the aesthetics of pornography that I must admit I fall short on the legalities of it sometimes. You know what I mean? Because I usually don't have the sound up. Oh, that's it.
Enough of that.
Yeah, I don't know what that is. It's one of those double-edged porn swords. Matt?
Yeah, I had a question. I've been looking for a job for a long time now. I'm 24. I'm a college graduate, and I'm just having a lot of hard time. I was wondering how to keep my spirits up.
What was your major?
Public administration.
Adam has come up with the perfect solution.
Yeah. True. Yeah, you want to get my ass fired, don't you?
I think this would be an interesting story.
All right. You want to know what my... I've given this to Drew many, many a time.
He was concerned that just... I'm pretty tough on my kids. I want them to be well-educated and whatnot. And he came up with a plan whereby if they didn't...
I have a plan for all morons. Not that you're one, Matt. But who knows? You could be king of the morons in this business. Let me tell you, go to your local radio station. Believe me. Just go. Just go claw on the door. They'll let you in. You'll answer the phone. You'll be GM of the frickin' place in about 6 months. That's how radio works. I learned that about radio. I had no idea that everyone in radio drove the van for the first year. It's an amazing, amazing phenomenon.
Some of them didn't even get to that level. They were like answering the phones or just entering ashtrays.
When my kid turns 18, I pull in front of the station. I don't even slow down. I throw his ass right out of the car, and I say, don't come back till you're running the place. And believe me, it's the greatest business in the world for that. Education to radio, complete waste of time. You're only wasting your own time with that.
It's so true, though. I mean, that's why it struck my fancy when you first came and told me that story. The guy that used to be – this show has been on the air in Los Angeles for years. Like, this is my 14th year. And the guy that used to empty the trash and run, like, errands for us – and this was on – the show was in the middle of the night – now runs MTV. He went all the way through K-Rock.
A huge pack of morons. And we're at a huge station in a huge market. And still everyone's an idiot. I mean, I include myself in that. But I've just never seen, I mean, every other job I've had, you had to be qualified. You had to have some kind of degree or at least know what you were doing. Radio, just big pack of morons running wild, making a ton of money and getting free tickets to every concert in town.
How about the guys that run the station, like the administrators and stuff?
Huge morons, Drew, all of them.
Just want to make sure that was clearly stated.
You got that on a cart, Mike?
Yeah, in case Adam's not here Monday, Sunday, yeah. We'll know why. All right.
Actually, the technical guys do know what they're doing. The guys who do the editing and
you're
the splicing
just,
and work the
in
boards.
Just in case Mike should drop something in to make you look
no,
good.
No, they do. They do know what they're doing. But everyone else just pretends like they know something. Joe.
Hey, Adam. Hi, Drew.
Hey, Joe.
Hi.
This past weekend, I was out of town, and my girlfriend and my best friend went to a party, and they ended up sleeping together. And I guess my best friend, he slipped some drug called the Spanish Fly, which makes the girl horny or something.
Oh, yeah.
And I guess that's the reason they ended up sleeping together.
Well, that's a load of BS.
Yeah, who told you that, him or she?
She.
She did. Oh, okay.
She can tell me about the story.
How convenient.
Yes.
Me and my best friend have been friends for like 6 years.
Right. Yeah, she's in love with you. She's totally devoted to you.
Yeah.
But he put some crushed cockroach legs in her margarita, and she could not help herself. Is that what happened, Joe?
That's what she said, yeah.
Yeah.
And this,
well, you can't blame her.
I know.
She was on the fly.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. It's worse than crack. Let me... Joe.
Yeah.
Joe, you don't believe this, do you?
That's why I called you guys.
He believes, though, that his best friend let him down in a big way, and so did his girlfriend.
Right.
I don't know how to resolve it. He wants to talk to it, but I'm afraid if we do, I'll have to knock his teeth out, because that's just how angry I am at
him. He wants to talk to who?
Huh?
He wants to talk to Joe.
My best friend, he wants to talk to me about it.
Well, what's going on with your girlfriend?
My girlfriend? Oh, she... I don't know. Me and her are kind of, you know, not close as we were because of this.
Yeah. Well, you know what, Joe? We're going to do something for you here.
All right.
We provide a service called Patch It Up with the Boyfriend. In a platonic way. You know what I'm saying?
I see.
I think you should give us this guy's number and we should give him a call.
The girlfriend.
Oh, the girlfriend?
Yeah.
See, Drew, when you do the universal phone thing, there's no sex by it, so I don't know what you're talking about. I think we could call both of them. You want to go with the girl? Girl's better.
I think my friend.
You want to go with a friend?
Yeah.
Drew's bobbing his head no. I think we should go with your girlfriend. But you're speaking to her, aren't you?
Yeah, we're speaking.
Yeah, it's just you're not communicating very well.
Yeah.
Because you're mad as hell.
Huh? Yeah.
Yeah, all right. All right.
My girlfriend, her parents are, like, very strict, and they don't allow guys to call her house.
Yeah. All right. So we can't call her.
We can't call her, but...
And you don't want to call him.
I want to call him because me and him have me and her have been.
All right. Drew is saying bogus.
Yeah, it's bogus.
Drew, how do you know?
Because he started out by saying, my friend wants to talk to you guys. I don't know if you picked that up. If you want to hear back on the tape, I'll be happy to play that for you. And that's when I had my doubts. That's why I said check the girl because he clearly didn't want us talking to her. And then when he wouldn't let us talk to her,
well,
it's obviously made up. And besides, anybody who's going through something like that is not... You're gonna have great ambivalence about divulging that kind of an intense experience in front of people. Now, they may have great confidence in you, Adam, and I can certainly understand that. But even so, even the highest degree of confidence in you is going to have a great deal of – you're going to feel the emotion. And I felt nothing. I felt the guy setting us up.
All right. And, Drew, you're right 100% of the time, and you're batting 1,000 on this show, so I'm going to go with you on that. Ryan.
Hey, how you doing?
Have you seen Pamela Gidley lately?
No, I haven't. I have to check her out.
You really, really owe it to yourself.
Would you buy her porno?
Would I buy her some pornography, or would I buy a porno that she was in?
If she was in a porno, would you buy it?
If she was in a porno, I would sell my car.
Mm-hmm.
I would mortgage my home.
Right.
Actually, I would give back the security deposit on my apartment because I don't own a home. And then I would walk barefoot over... broken glass to obtain that particular film.
So, in other words, she's okay.
She is all right.
All right.
She's here now to back me up on that. Pamela, you're all right, aren't you? I told her she could do whatever she wanted.
Wow.
Just don't steal any of the equipment.
That was the other thing I told her.
Well, I usually pay $4.95 a minute to hear that kind of stuff.
Well, stay with us, Ryan. If your question is good, you can get about $2 out of this. Go ahead.
I was calling about melatonin.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody seems to be saying that it's such a good thing to have, and your brain already has it anyway, so what's wrong with more?
Well, your brain, for instance, already has things like morphine compounds,
right.
Okay?
I just bought melatonin yesterday. Well, no, 2 days ago.
We've said on the show many times, there's no free lunch with Mother Nature. And although your brain has receptors for pot, it doesn't mean you have to deliver pot to the brain. And because you have receptors for endorphins and morphine-like compounds, giving the brain a lot of morphine doesn't necessarily help the physiology of the brain. Melatonin does help people sleep. I've seen everything alleged that it cures cancer and it's going to cure mood disturbances and it's going to save the world. It's obvious when a substance comes out as a panacea and a cure-all that it's just absolutely ridiculous.
Every 6 months something comes out. Put this mushroom on top of this thing. It'll duplicate itself. You'll drink the tea. You have the strength of 1,000 men. Right. Hey, fish oil.
Right.
Remember fish oil was all over the place? Right. Here's what they do, and then we're going to get to you, Pamela. But I have to explain the world.
All
no,
right.
Not you and your crazy, whacked-out, overpaid, drug-popping doctor buddies. I'm talking about the man.
The man, all
here's right. what the man does. Every once in a while, the man does a study, and he goes to some distant part of the world, and he takes some Eskimo, and he slaps a cadaver down on the table, and he cuts him open, and he finds out he doesn't have any artery blockage.
Right.
So then he goes, What do Eskimos eat?
Right.
And they go, seal blubber?
Right.
All right, then.
Right.
There
That's right.
it is.
That's right.
Now we're going to make it in a pill form.
Right.
And we're going to have a bunch of stupid actors loading up on
hey
it.
Now.
Oh,
hey,
no, not
easy,
you, baby.
Buddy.
Not you.
Easy.
I meant Hollywood types. I meant they, not you.
All right. But melatonin probably will have some useful benefit. But like with any pharmacologic agent, there are going to be things about it that we're going to find out as widespread use continues. And we'll find out what's going to happen. I used to prescribe tryptophan, which was an amino acid you could get over the counter, and you could
the stuff that's in turkey, right?
Yeah.
It make you go to sleep.
Right.
But there was an outbreak of this thing called EMS, eosinophilomyelitis syndrome. I had a patient develop it; it was devastating. And guess what? I don't take melatonin because of having witnessed that.
Speaking of devastating afflictions, Drew said he got to have a peek at your rash.
You want to see
out in the hall? Well, yeah, actually.
You see?
And yeah, where is that? Oh. Oh, wow. You know, I have mixed feelings about that. I really do.
Drew's on the floor.
Wow. Wow.
You want to lick me from coast to coast?
Oh, well, I think I'm going to stop somewhere in the Midwest and actually just take
bloody
a break.
Gross, isn't it?
Wow.
It's scary.
Is it anywhere else? I mean,
no,
not that I need to
it.
See.
That's it.
Now, what is that?
It's
that's
so funny
chicken
to watch
pox.
A layperson react to a little rash. You
well,
would have thought
a little rash,
I just,
Drew,
you would have thought
you
had just shot him with an Uzi
Wait
or something.
Wait a minute. Stop there. Right
I know
now.
It's painful, but it's just a little. It's a rash. You know,
it's not a rash. That's not a rash.
That's a rash.
This is scary, painful stuff.
It's very painful.
Oh, let me tell you.
This is not a rash. An
eruption. Excuse me. It's
eruption.
Eruption.
Thank you. They're
yeah,
like that's blisters.
That's Mount St. Helens.
Exactly.
Are you kidding? Oh, could you imagine if you just like picked her up at a Red Onion or something? Could you imagine going home with Pamela on a one-night stand and hold on. Let me go out to the van. I got something in the glove box. Oh, Jesus.
Thank God for the cough button because I'm pushing it.
Wow. All right, let's get the show back on track. Come on, everyone's a pro here. Come on, Drew, you're a doctor, for Christ's sake. Do you laugh? You laugh that way when you're old?
I'm not laughing at Pamela. It's you that
oh,
is funny.
Okay.
Your reaction to this thing, you would have thought she brought out some kind of a weapon and began smacking you with it.
Well, because it was like, here's how my mind was going. It's going, hey, where's that rash? Hey, look at that. Hey, little leg.
Little
hey,
further,
little
further.
Oh. Oh. It was kind of like the crying game a little bit, you know?
It hurts. It Have hurts. Some sympathy.
I certainly will.
You're and a liar!
I will. No, and I'm working up some kind of pox outbreak right now myself that I'm going to show you during the 11 o'clock hour. So, Pamela Gidley...
What?
Let's talk about your life. Let's talk about strange luck. How's that going for you? You're on the slot right before.
It's over.
The show's over?
The party is.
Oh, what are you doing? A little
over.
All right. What kind of medication is she on, Drew?
I'm really worried about you more. The paranoia and all the stuff you're manifesting tonight is very disturbing.
That's right. He hasn't had chicken pox. Yeah.
No, I think I have, but I certainly haven't had him there.
Where's
on my hip. That's not a bad place.
Yeah, that was kind of frontal hip, though. You know what I'm saying? I mean, during the 70s, I think that I would have seen a little hair. Do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I mean, now with today's bikinis and the trends and all that, I think it was safe. But, you know.
I'm the hairless wonder.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, I keep myself trimmed a little bit, you know, because it stores moisture. I talc. I use a lot of talc. Drew and I talk about that.
No, really? You talk about that.
All right,
that.
But let me ask you something.
Sort of moist down there? Is that the problem?
You've been with men before, obviously.
Yeah, once or twice.
You know that guys, and the more man you are,
sweaty balls.
All right, you know. All right, the cat is out of the sack,
just
as it were.
Just go ahead and say it.
I like to talc up down there because I like to stay fresh for my lady pals.
Hey.
You know, do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I hear you.
Now, wouldn't you appreciate it if your man, you know, dumped like a bin of talc down there before he went out?
Well, you'd be tasting a little chalky, wouldn't you?
Well, that's why you dust off like an umpire cleaning home plate before you yell batter up.
Yeah, I would appreciate it if someone were to do that sort of preparation. Sure.
Now, could I rub some calamine lotion or something on the affected areas?
You want to touch one?
You get it.
Would I get it?
You could get infected.
Well, what if I put a glove on and put calamine lotion on?
It feels really weird.
It wouldn't help Pamela any, I don't think.
Yeah, I know, but it'd do wonders for me.
Pam was actually on a new medication called Valtrex.
She certainly
that I
is.
Found, hey. That I found searching through the internet all by myself.
There's another one. Resources. Are you on Famvir or Valtrex?
Valtrex.
There's another one called Famvir also that is good also, by the way. But I don't think it's been approved for the zoster, the shingles yet.
Right.
But Valtrex is a lot like Zovirax, just easier to take.
There's no side effects. Supposedly, it's one up. You don't get the headaches, you don't get the nausea.
It's metabolized into Zovirax in your body, basically. And you don't get a lot of the neurologic side effects.
But it's not an antibiotic.
It's an antiviral. Yeah.
So that's why I'm not getting a yeast infection.
All right. Drew, once again, Drew sucked all the sex out of the room. God bless you, Drew. Chris, you're on LoveLine with Pamela Gidley and her pox.
Chris.
How's it going?
Great.
Chris, you want to come see my pox?
I thought we had something special, baby.
Hey, I got kind of a problem.
Uh-oh.
I was dating this girl for about 6 months, and getting along pretty good, and found out she was pregnant. And
With your child?
Yeah.
Okay.
Things weren't really going very well. I mean, we were fighting all the time. And I came to what we thought was a mutual decision. I mean, I thought that she felt the same way, that we needed to kind of break off the relationship for a while, see if we can get things worked out between us, kind of organized. I don't know, I thought it was better to have a relationship with a kid as two adults who could get along as opposed to two who fight all the time.
Mm-hmm.
So we kind of got apart and she flipped.
Did you get married?
No, we didn't.
Okay. What did she flip? What do you mean?
Well, she went crazy, basically. I was living with her for a while, and when I moved out, she was really hard to get my stuff back from her.
You mean you basically broke up with her?
Well, yeah.
And that's why she flipped out.
So you drove her crazy, Chris.
Well, see,
you're to blame. All you men are to blame.
Ultimately, we are.
Well, in the conversation we had, though, I mean, we talked about it, and I mean, I was, you know, getting the impression from her that she felt the same way. Because, I mean, we knew we weren't getting along.
And this was while she was pregnant?
Yes. Well, this was like when she first was pregnant.
How did it manifest itself? What did she do? Give us a couple for instances.
Well, first of all, I would call and make it, you know, set up times to come over and pick up my stuff. She wouldn't be there, wouldn't let me in, stuff like that.
Sounds totally psychotic, doesn't it?
Listen.
No, I mean, the point
don't
is,
make those fast judgments.
No, the point is, he's being sarcastic. I'm being facetious.
Chris, how were you to her? Were you the nice guy? Were you a good...
I thought I was pretty civil with her. I mean, I didn't ever.
It's,
you know,
being
really
civil
do
doesn't prevent people from feeling violated and abandoned, especially at a vulnerable time like that in their life. I mean, come on.
Like, women have enough problems with hormones already. When you're pregnant, things are going nuts.
And after pregnancy, it's even, sometimes even worse.
And so you're saying women are screwed before pregnancy, during pregnancy, and after pregnancy?
I mean, immediately after, it really can get worse.
But it all gets better after menopause, Chris, if you can hold out another 35, 40 years. How old is she?
She's 19.
All right, she's 19. She's pregnant, and her relationship is ending, and she's, you know,
she's
stressed.
The real
problem comes, though, is she went out and got a restraining order against me, and the kid is being born in 2 weeks, and I can't afford a lawyer, and according to the people I talk to, I make too much for legal aid.
Wow.
So I'm kind of stuck between a rock and a hard place.
Jeez.
And I can't make any kind of contact with her, so I'm kind of wondering how on earth I'm going to be able to have any kind of custody of this kid.
All right, we got to wrap this up in about 15 seconds, unfortunately, but I'm going to tell him what he needs to
All right,
do.
Go ahead.
What he needs to do is just sit back and sit on his hands and bite his lip for a few weeks, maybe a month. Let her have the kid. Let her cool down. Let her not feel so threatened, and then approach it when she's more sane and the tension levels died down. Come at her, maybe write her a letter, be civil, get the restraining order lift, and start working back into visitation rights. Am I right?
Yeah, it's so complicated.
All right, just agree then, would you?
All right, well, restraining order lift. Have you ever had one levied at you?
I had to kill the judge, yeah. We'll be back with Pamela and her pox after this.
LoveLine.
Look deep into this jingle. You are getting sleepy. Sleepy. LoveLine will be right back. You will listen.
Hello, this is Jackie Mason. Do you know what LoveLine does? They straighten out the problems with your love life. And we do it better than anybody.
Oh, yeah, Jackie Mason. Huge fan of the show. Want to leave at what? No bagels? Jackie, could you do a little shtick? Could you do a little comedy? What? No pay? I'm supposed to come here like a monkey? Stayed for about 10 minutes and left, pissed off with no bagels. Phone numbers 1-800-LOVE-191, 1-800-568-3191, faxes 310-854-4455. This is Adam Carolla, that's Dr. Drew. I know, Doc.
All right.
That's Pamela Gidley.
Hi.
Pamela and I are both Geminis, we were just discussing.
Southpaws.
Yeah, both left-handed Geminis, and I don't know if that makes us... Are you incompatible with your own sign? You have to go out like Gemini's. Like I think I don't know what I know what my traits are. I think it's napping and masturbating a lot.
Are you suggesting you're incompatible with Pamela? Is that already what you're pointing out?
We may be because we're
my
the same sign.
Hi David. My boyfriend, he's right on the cusp. He's a Gemini Cancer.
Oh.
He's technically a Gemini.
Right. And is a Gemini, you're supposed to have a couple of personalities, right?
Yeah.
Because I think you have three.
At least two.
Because you got mine. Because every time someone says that to me, I go, you're nuts because I barely have one personality. Like, I have, like, 3/4 of a personality, much less two. All right.
At least you're honest.
Damien.
Yeah.
Hey, you're on LoveLine.
Hey, cool. I got a little problem.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to ask my girlfriend to marry me, but I want to do it and, like, tape it over the air so she can remember it for the rest of her life.
Oh, okay.
Isn't that cute?
They can divvy that up in the divorce.
Yeah.
You mean you want to call her to the... Is she there with you now?
Well, she's in the back room. I can get her on the other line because I got 2 phones, if that's cool.
That's cool.
Yeah, get her on.
Where are you calling from?
I'm calling from Kathy's Valley.
Aren't you too young to get married?
No.
How old are you?
23.
You're too young to get married.
Is that too young?
I think so.
What are you doing, cursing it? He's asking her to marry him.
How old is she?
She's 21.
Too young to get married.
That's fine.
Too young.
That's 44 if you
too
add him
young,
up.
Too young.
She's in her prime condition right now.
Don't you think they should
trust me. 21, she's not in her prime.
But here's the deal, Pamela. They've decided.
Whatever.
Do you understand? It's not one of those. If anyone knows why these two should not
together?
Be brought together.
You live together?
We got a
so what's the problem? You're married by common law, so I'm...
Yeah, well, we want that paper thing.
You want the paper. What are you going to do with the paper?
Well, it's just one of those commitments, you know, that you got to take off.
Right, yeah. Let's let them...
Pamela, you want to read them some quick statistics about young marriages, or can we get on with this?
Yeah, they don't last! Sorry, you're going to ask her to marry, and I'm sitting here giving you crap.
Yeah, that's her fourth
really
personality.
Nice.
Go ahead, Damien, bring her on.
The one that doesn't know protocol.
Hey, Spring.
Oh, my God. He's in trouble.
What's her
She's
name?
She's still going to go to summer, winter, and fall, you know, before she gets to her prom.
Yeah, when we have kids, we're going to have autumn, fall, winter.
Oh, my God.
That's
so
wonderful.
Scary.
are hippies more apt to Hello? Have a successful... Oh.
Hello.
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 Spring.
Yeah.
Spring.
Have you blossomed yet, Spring?
What?
Spring. You know, men produce more testosterone in the spring. We were talking
That's
about
true.
This, but I digress. Damien has a question he wants to ask you.
Damien.
Does she know she's on the radio?
Do you know you're on the radio, Spring?
Yeah, I kind of figured that out.
Okay, well, our friend Damien has a very important question he'd like an answer to.
Okay.
Well, babe, even though most marriages don't last, I just want to tell you that I love you very, very much, and that I know it's ours will, and I want to marry you.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Honey, get out here.
We're like...
Honey, it's time to spread your seeds.
I will marry you, babe.
You will? Cool, because I already got the rings being made.
Oh, good.
All right, do you guys have any vows?
Nope.
All right, I have some.
Okay.
Good effing luck! Sorry.
That was the voice of ill reason, Pamela Gidley.
She sounds like Ursula.
Oh.
I mean, that's that kind of venom coming out.
Settle down now. This is a beautiful moment. Have you ever been proposed to by a guy who was sober?
Actually,
no.
No?
Actually, I don't drink, so.
Okay, but all I'm saying...
Are you a vegan?
A vegan?
Yeah.
What's that?
You don't eat anything but
Okay, I guess if you don't know it,
April.
You're not one, so don't worry.
or Spring or whatever. Yeah, just call her April.
Okay. I just got that.
Yeah, we're on a 6-second delay here.
Oh, whatever. Stupid kids getting married.
Damien, please. You know, she reminds me of Kennedy.
Yeah, yeah.
You just don't know. You're kind of
wait,
torn.
Wait, Dr. Drew. I think one of my pox is oozing.
Yes.
Oh my God, it's going right through the sheer pants. You better take those off immediately.
I have these loose pants on to make
Babe,
me feel
get
comfortable.
Get the paper towel.
Pam, you know,
good
Pamela,
luck, young lovebirds in the spring. What's your name? The guy, Earth.
Damien.
Or Damien.
Yeah.
Yeah. So spring.
Uh-huh.
You've accepted?
Yes.
You two will be wed?
Yes.
Yep.
This is our first marriage, and when have you set a date yet, Damien?
Well, actually, she's been talking about August 24th, so, you know, it sounds like a good one.
Oh, yeah, August 24th. I can see the significance.
Have
that's,
you guys been eating
Tuesday.
A lot of those crazy mushrooms?
What was that?
Have you guys been eating all those crazy mushrooms?
No.
Actually, we've been picking them, but we haven't eaten any.
No.
All right, so you guys are getting married.
Yeah.
All right, here's what I suggest. You live together now?
Yep.
Move apart. Move apart tonight.
Now you're talking my language.
Because the marriage is not going to go down with you two.
I'm packing my bags right now.
That's right. Pack your bags. You can't see the bride until the marriage.
That'll work.
All right, Damien?
Okay. Bye-bye.
All right, Spring?
Okay.
Good luck to you.
Appreciate it.
All right. So you
I'm
don't
so
think
cruel.
It's going to last?
No.
Yes, you're very cruel.
I'm not cruel. I'm just truthful.
Do you know what it's like to be young and in love?
Sure, I was there.
How old are you?
Old enough.
You got a boyfriend?
Yeah, I love him to death.
Serious?
Yeah.
Really?
David, he was on your show.
He was?
Yeah.
David?
He's in the Vandals, you know, that dumb punk group called the Vandals.
You actresses are all alike.
Oh, piss off.
Oh, I gotta
That's
get some guys
true.
In a band. He's real angry at the world. Boy, does that turn me on. You guys are all the same.
You just keep spewing that crap out of your mouth. Go
Why
ahead.
Don't you
I
go
like
out with a nice guy with a real job, huh?
He's the nicest guy with a real job.
I would treat you like a queen. You know that?
Would you?
Yeah.
Really?
Wait a minute. You told to go with a nice guy with a real job.
Oh, yeah. All right. All right. Forget that. All right, Drew, you want to go back to the phone?
Is that why you asked me about not stealing any equipment? Because
yeah.
They stole a lot of equipment. Maybe that's
no,
what...
No, no. They're fine, upstanding young gents, the Vandals. Sure, they're the Vandals. Of course they're great guys. Lena.
Hi.
Lena?
I guess so.
I know somebody. You're not my manager, are you?
No.
Okay, good.
15.
Lena.
Yeah?
You're on LoveLine.
Hi.
Hi.
I just wanted to wish Amy say the happy birthday, and I want to say you guys are the greatest. I listen to you every night and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
But I have a question about herpes.
Mm-hmm.
I heard from a friend that you can get it from drinking from other people's sodas and using other people's lipstick and stuff.
Yeah.
Do that again.
That's actually true. But herpes viruses are very common on people's mouths. You ever had a cold sore?
Yeah.
That's herpes.
I know a sure way you can get herpes. You can go
touch me.
Suck on Pamela's hip.
That actually is the zoster is a herpes virus.
Oh, herpes, yeah.
And that is what herpes can look like.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, Lord knows how you got that. How did you
but
get that?
But it's not,
it's in the environment, the zoster. It's not to be confused.
It's in the herpes family.
Right, not to be confused with herpes
so
simplex.
So is in chicken pox.
That's
so
correct.
Let's make that clear so that people don't freak out like, right. Oh, shingles is herpes.
No, it's a herpes type virus, and right. It's not herpes simplex. But herpes simplex can appear like that, just right. Doesn't appear in a big streak across.
All right, but Pamela, seriously, do the folks at TV Guide know that you're stricken with this sort of STD all over your nether regions?
STD.
I mean, would that pull you off the list?
No. In fact, they'd give me my own very own private page because they wouldn't want me touching anybody else.
Now, all right, I'm sorry.
Lena, it is highly contagious, and things like what we call fomites, these things that are inanimate that the virus can get onto, can then transmit it to other people.
Don't drink after anybody else. I'm a germ freak.
Contagious virus like herpes is one you can get by sharing utensils and things.
Right.
Okay. All right, so we're all caught up. This has become the Pox, Herpes, Pus, and Sore Show. With your host, Adam Carolla and Dr. Drew.
Singles with shingles.
Today's celebrity with... with an outbreak is Pamela Gidley. You know her from Strange Luck. We'll be back after this.
Call LoveLine 1-800-LOVE-191. LoveLine. We'll be right back.
We're back. We got more LoveLine. We have more Pamela Gidley. She is a breath of fresh air. You don't know whether, I don't know, she's one of these women you don't know whether to just molest her or shove a sock in her mouth. It's, but it's definitely one of those. It could
Thank
be
you.
A little
That's so
each,
sweet
actually.
Of you. You're a doll. You are.
No, you have a lot of spunk, a lot of chutzpah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Imagine that.
Yes, you're just a breath of fresh air. The phone number is 1-800-LOVE-191. The fax number, 310-854-4455. Now, I feel guilty because we're not talking about you. You're the guest on the show. You have projects.
Yeah.
You have films.
Yeah.
You're doing some directing. You're doing some producing.
Yeah.
You have things to plug.
Yeah.
Can't we talk about that for just a moment?
Well, yeah, but you just keep yakking away, so.
All right. Well, go ahead. You tell us.
Well, I you know, I like to answer questions.
All right. I'm going to ask you. Kiss and Tell.
Yeah.
That's a movie.
That's a movie.
It's not out yet.
No.
You produced it.
Yes.
And you co-whatted it.
Created it.
Co-created it. But it's an improvisational film.
Yes, no script.
Well,
over 100 actors, took a long time to do.
No, well, how does that work? What do you mean no script?
No script. You sort of have a storyline in mind, maybe an outcome, possibly. And you just sort of get actors together and discuss what potentially could this story be and let it go from there.
This sounds like a disaster.
It's crazy.
Well, then what do you do? Edit the whole thing together and make sense of it?
Exactly. How smart of you. That's exactly what you do.
And did it work?
Yeah, we're doing sound right now, and I think it's terrific. I think it's really funny. I think it's incredibly subversive. I think it's
And this is going to
be like myself. It'll be a breath of fresh air.
And will this be like the like art house kind of stuff, or are you going to try to get this in a wide release, or how's this work?
Well, I mean, you know, you're talking good luck trying to get anything under $50 million into a wide release. No.
Right, especially when you just take a bunch of actors, put them in a pen, and start a camera.
Yeah.
But you're going to put this out at like New Art and stuff like that.
New Art, Lemley's, you know, all those sort of places. There's so many little quote art house theaters around these days that. That's sort of taking place of old-style mainstream films.
And is anyone in it? Are you in it?
I'm in it.
And
I actually started out just doing something really small, and it ended up sort of being a bit bigger because of the whole arena of doing improv. Actors would other jobs and become asshole. I mean, you know,
a-holes.
Jerks.
Yeah, say that. And once you get going, I mean, I could see you taking up a good 45 minutes of that film.
Easy. No, it's great. We got a really good group of people involved too.
Any other faces or names that we might recognize?
Let's see. Peter Green, Heather Graham.
Oh, Peter Green.
Hill.
He's a big a-hole.
Yeah, he is.
He's
a big a-hole.
He is a head case.
Absolutely.
He was on. Oh, I did stand in.
Don't
for
get
him.
Me going on actors, because I'll just bash.
All right, but let's just bash Peter Green for just 1 second. He was in the movie.
He was
Judgment Night. Judgment Night.
I didn't see it.
All
Isn't
right,
that some Stallone movie?
No, Judgment Night was Emilio Estevez and Dennis Leary and Cuba Gooding Jr. And they all got, like, their Winnebago went off in the south side of Chicago, and they had to get back to town. And Peter Green.
I didn't see it. Yeah, go on.
He was just a huge head case.
He's pretty
all right.
scary.
All right. Enough inside talk here. Ed.
Hey, how are you?
Hey, you're on LoveLine.
All right, I had a quick comment and a question for Dr. Drew.
Mm-hmm.
I had a feeling last night listening to the show with Heidi Fleiss that there was a whole side of that whole prostitution thing that never came up, and I know that Heidi probably catered to maybe the top 10% or 5% of people who solicit. But there's another whole side of that that really does perpetuate the things that I think Dr. Drew tried to bring up a couple times with drug abuse and perpetuating abuse and things like that.
Right.
And I was kind of disappointed that didn't come up.
Well, wait a minute. Drew did hit on that quite a few times. I mean, he didn't talk about the underprivileged prostitutes, but he talked about the so-called high-class prostitutes.
No, I just talked about
Well, relax, Doc. I'm blowing your horn over here for a second. Just cool your jets, pal.
Right.
He talked about how even the ones that were making $3,000 or $4,000 a night had drug addictions, had family problems.
I know, but it seemed like she really painted it to be a glamorous picture initially.
You know what?
Didn't you see that Tori Spelling you the other night? What was it called? Co-ed call girl.
Oh,
is that
so
a
frightening.
Movie of the week.
Oh yeah, it was just nasty. All about how this young college co-ed gets seduced into the whole escort service prostitution thing. And
I've worked myself in counseling for.
Now they're all a bunch of losers, bunch of hobags.
But, wow,
scumbags.
But yeah,
send those letters addressing to Pamela Gidley.
She actually made some comments to me at the end of the show that. Showed me that she felt much more strongly than she was able to express on the air. She has some, I guess, legal issues that prevent her from doing this. And she, I don't think, would disagree with you.
No, okay? and Ed, I agree. I mean, she represented the $5,000 night girls, and that's why we were talking about that.
Exactly.
And yeah, there is a sort of dark underbelly and a seedy side in the streetwalkers and the ones that are hooked on heroin. And the ones that are making $50 and the ones that are blowing Hugh Grant, you know, I mean, this is the other side of this. But my feeling is this is going to continue legal or not. I think if you legalized it, I think if the pimps weren't taking 80% of the money, I think if the pimps weren't threatening them physically, if the pimps weren't getting them hooked on drugs, if they were tested, that things could be cleaned up, that things could be taken care of. You're always going to have people willing to spend money on sex. Like,
right.
I'm going to offer Pamela here some...
Give it to
she
me.
She just gave me a look, so I ran out of steam. But... But
ask
do you
me
know
what
I'm
ask
saying?
Ask me. Ask me something, please.
I was going to give you like $20 to like...
I'll
show you my pox for 20.
Show me your pox again.
I'll show you the end of the room.
Alex, let me see pox for $400. She's an out-of-control actress whose career's almost over. She makes improvisational movies. That'd be Pamela Gidley. Correct.
In the form of a question, please.
Who is Pamela Gidley? Sorry, Alex. All right, Ed.
All right, my question is, after listening to you guys for a long time, I kind of don't even know how you do it night after night, some of the totally dysfunctional situations that keep perpetuating themselves.
Actually, it's – well, go ahead.
Well, Drew doesn't care, so.
No, no, it's the fact that they're always there and don't even – the very first time I came in the show over a decade ago, that was what shocked me, was this is where they come with these problems. And this is what I hope to be a springboard and a compass to get them into something more appropriate.
One of the things that you just got a couple words out of your mouth last night about was the morality issue involved in a lot of this. And I know that the church and state, that's a big separation.
Right.
But I think one of the problems is a lot of times people lump up morality with religion.
Right. And I think it is more of a philosophical issue of what is right and what is wrong that we arrive at through the use of reason.
Right. So, I mean, do you feel that that's the underlying reason behind a lot of this, that there's no moral structure to the family and now they're taking it out of the schools and, and the people who legislate in the legislature who are...
Men have no morals. Men are the ones who are buying it. God dang it.
I just wanted to take it out of the arena of the religious aspects and ethical aspects if we were going to have that discussion.
Yeah, put it back in the
but
penis.
We never did.
Would you relax?
But I really do have concerns for the how ill the people are that you often get into these things and the fact that they get caught in them, they can't get out and they don't get help and it's a very
and that's what scares me is that's the future. I'm in my mid-30s and you look at these are the people that we're going to be relying on and it seems like it's just a perpetual
it is right now it is and hopefully
you know when we look to the people the leaders of the country and that and. They're
and they're buying them, too.
Ed, this isn't the McLaughlin group. Please.
I know. There's just, you guys
I'm this close to killing myself, Ed. Pamela's got a boyfriend in the pox. You're bringing me down. Drew sucked the sex out of the room. I got a big lump on my palm that Pamela just rubbed. You want to rub that again?
I just wanted to end with a compliment.
Ew, that's so gross.
Hold on here. Ed, go ahead.
I think you guys really do a great service to a lot of people that it's easier to talk to somebody on the phone than it is to talk to a friend or a counselor at school. And I think you guys are really doing a world of service to a lot of people.
Thanks, Ed. Keep listening.
Appreciate it.
Oh, boy. You ever gone out with any guys like Ed?
That talks too much?
Yeah, and they got the weight of the world.
No, I like those quiet giant types, you know?
You like those quiet guys with, like, the guitars and the big paychecks, don't you?
Yeah.
Yeah.
No!
Now, how'd you meet your man? You went and saw him at a concert, right?
I pulled his pants down.
On stage?
Tried to.
No, come on. How'd you meet him?
It's true.
Come on.
It's true.
What do you mean?
It's very true.
Tell us a story.
My best friend was, she did a video for some dumb band. I forget their name. Oh, shoot.
Yeah, so?
And she met up with this guy named Josh, the drummer, and he was a cute young guy, you know, and they sort of became friends. And he was also playing in the Vandals, and he invited her and myself to go see them at the Whiskey a few years back. And we went a little dressed up, let's say.
Uh-huh. Hanging out?
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
She got a little pissed, a little drunk, and... I was sort of trying to take care of her, and she dared me, double dared me, triple dared me to go pull his pants down. Drew's, he doesn't want to hear it.
On stage?
So I did, I attempted to. He says, you know, David will say that I did not succeed. But I think I did.
And that was it? Then
he hated me. No, he said something about, you know, something to Josh about his Hollywood friends and how not funny they were. And so ever since then I thought, well, you know.
But
screw you.
But this isn't the drummer's pants you pulled down.
No, this was the singer's.
Oh, okay.
This was the singer's.
Good. Good. Good.
But now we're together and I love him and he loves me.
All right, fantastic.
Caller, caller.
All right,
caller,
all right.
Caller,
God bless
caller,
both of you.
Caller.
Yes, Randy.
Yes.
You're
Randy.
On LoveLine.
Hey.
Hey.
I have hyperbilirubinemia.
Oh, Jesus.
That's right.
Go to the doctors.
I need the doctor.
Yeah, what's the deal?
I have hyperbilirubinemia due to liver disease from alcohol abuse.
Yeah.
And what? I want to know if my sperm is effective.
Now, is
effective?
That,
what sperm?
Wait
You're
a minute.
You're not going to produce
there
much.
Is none
but
left.
If you have such severe alcoholism.
Two people talk.
All right, look. The bilirubin causes basically as a result of bile sludging in your liver. It can't get through your liver.
No.
backed up, get backed up in your blood, and you get you can turn yellow from it and whatnot. But the bilirubin is not going to harm you at all. The problem is if you're drinking that much alcohol, you're not going to produce much sperm.
Well, I've stopped drinking, but it's taking its time to get out of my body.
Still, when you have that kind of liver disease, your estrogen levels tend to be rather high. Long periods of alcohol exposure shrink and damage the testes. Your sperm count will go way down. It tends to damage the nerves down there in the pelvic region and also thereby causing a lot of sexual dysfunction. So it does have quite a bit of impact on male sexual function.
Well, I guess what I'm asking you is how long am I going to have to wait before it's semen-ish?
it may not ever come back, possibly.
Next lifetime. Yeah.
Are you bummed out now?
Well.
That's it. That's it. The whole masturbatory scheme for the weekend has been set back 2 days, Drew. We'll be back.
Call Loveline, 1-800-LOVE-191. The phone call is free. The advice is free. Then it's up to you. Loveline, we'll be right back.
Well, as I walked down the halls of the fabulous Westwood One, I noticed the gents from Hagfish were here and raring to go, so they're going to be coming in about 11:30. Until then, we have the lovely Pamela Gidley. You know her from Strange Luck. And
I was just looking at Hagfish.
Yeah.
Hagfish.
It's pretty crowded in here today.
Hagfish.
But I like that. I like an audience. The phone number, 1-800-LOVE-191, 1-800-568-3191. The fax number, 310-854-4455. Faxes like...
Got a fax from University of California, Irvine. A fellow who's faxed before to remind us of some interesting data. He was pointing out here, we were talking, I guess, last night or the night before about teen pregnancies. And so, you know, remember, they were talking to a 14-year-old that got pregnant and whatnot. And he points out that somewhere between 60% and 80% of teenagers that are pregnant are impregnated by males in their 20s and substantially older.
Right. So it's the old guys knocking up.
It's adults having sex with young teenagers.
See? Men.
Pigs.
Men.
Also why the laws are the way they are.
You're all a bunch of pigs, horny bastards.
It's true. That's why we always get uncomfortable when guys are talking, you know, these girls are talking about older guys. It's not appropriate. It's not right. The laws are there to protect them. They're not
the innocent.
Well, they're not in developmentally in a position to be making good decisions. They're just not. They're victims better, more than they are participants. Then here's another fact. Would you consider the following losing one's virginity? The guy is inside for about 30 seconds and then pulls out because of pain.
I don't know. Should we take a vote?
Go ahead, you guys.
Wait a minute. I think it's time for one of the famous Loveline secret votes. Now, you either write a Y for yay or an N for nay. Now, don't show me. Don't show me because we're going to build some anticipation here because I know radio. I know how this goes. Now, no peeking.
We have 10 seconds
no
to
peeking.
Do this.
No, we're gonna come back after the 10 seconds with the big answer because in about 5 seconds, we're going to break for 10 seconds. And then we're going to come back with this tremendous answer.
What am I?
Stupid!
This is Loveline on
radio station.
Okay. Did you draw your Y for yay or your N for nay?
We clarify the vote that yes, she is not a virgin.
Yes, she has some bananas.
No, she is still a virgin. Am I still a virgin? Am I still a virgin?
Why she's a virgin?
No. The question was, am I still a virgin?
Yes.
Yes or no?
Why means you're no longer a virgin.
I can't even write this wire, and how stupid is that?
Would you write it?
What this poor, stupid person would even... Oh, I'm sorry.
Would you?
Oh, this is my card.
Yeah.
You wrote D.B. Sweeney on it. Oh, God, okay.
Would you... Just write Y or N. Y means
yellow.
She's not a virgin. Anne's yelling at me. All right, I'm holding mine up. I got a Y. Thank you. All right, big Y. All right. It was an attempt, Dan.
That was a lot of
That's
fun.
All. That's all.
Who's the producer of this show?
Include the listeners in what just went down.
That's the one that just yelled at me.
It was a unanimous vote.
Yeah, it was a unanimous vote. I'm sorry. Yes, you are not a virgin. Drew, I'm going to let you pick a call because you're fastly becoming a virgin, Drew. Seth.
Hello, everybody.
Hey, you're on LoveLine.
Thank you. I have a question for Dr. Drew.
Yes, sir. Go ahead.
My girlfriend and I have been going out for about 6 months now. Mm-hmm. And we started having sex, well, a long time ago, but we recently have been not using a condom because she's on the pill. Mm-hmm. And when we don't use a condom, she gets really irritated. Nothing visibly, no redness, no, like, chafing or anything, but she gets really irritated. Mm-hmm. And it goes away when we do use a condom.
Hmm. Something only persists for a while afterwards? Does it go on for days?
It can go on for maybe a day or two or just a couple hours. It varies.
Does she have any discharge or anything like that?
No.
Okay.
What's up with that?
I'm sitting here racking my brain thinking of, like, every problem I've ever
had. Yeah, I mean, there are very peculiar
well,
things.
You know.
Judging from your right side, I say you have quite a bit of experience in the problem department.
Easy, Adam.
All right. Can I have another quick look?
Sure. You want to see?
Yeah, just a quickie. All right, go ahead, Drew. You answer. I want to look at the hip.
All right. There are peculiar...
Yikes.
Yes.
Are we done, guys?
Yeah.
Okay. There are peculiar reactions that people can get, such as actually sort of an allergic reaction to semen. There's that sort of thing. There can be the fact that...
Oh, that's such a shame.
Perhaps that his fluid somehow changes...
I'm allergic to cum!
...changes the environment in there that creates perhaps an infection of some kind, allows a certain bacteria to overgrow.
Because most of the time, people call in, they complain that they have problems with the condom.
Right.
Now, could this be a lubrication thing?
I was going to say that. I was going to ask, are you using lubrication?
We're simpatico on the condom thing.
We're
meaning, if the condom... Was,
I love you, Adam.
I love you, man. If the condom was lubricated, then and you're not wearing the condom now, then you're not getting the lubrication.
Do you use lubrication when you're not having, when you're not using a condom?
Well, I usually wait till she's plenty lubricated by herself.
All right, so it's not that.
And the condoms that you use, do they have lubrication already on them?
Yes, they do.
Well, there you go. That could be a good indication right there.
Again,
being a girl and having used both, you know. Try lubrication when you're not using a condom.
She needs to get checked out just to make sure, again, it's not an infectious problem here.
Does he need to get checked out?
Go to the allergy doctor because I'm allergic to cum!
It's not likely to be him.
Well, I have one other question.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Okay. It has to do with my work.
Yeah.
I work for a temporary agency, and mm-hmm. I've been working for a specific company for almost 6 months now, and they're about to make me a permanent employee. But I was just they just instated a new policy this year.
Drug testing.
Yeah, you got it.
Yes.
The only drug the only drug I really do now.
Marijuana.
You got it.
That'll stay in your system for up to a couple of weeks.
That's right.
A couple of weeks?
Yeah.
You'll no longer be a Kelly
Start
boy.
Start filling out those unemployment applications.
Yeah.
They're going to take that green blazer away from you and send you out on the street when they find that.
And if the marijuana is more important to you than maintaining your job,
not only
then
are you
really
out of work, but your girlfriend's allergic to cum!
As soon as I found out that I was a candidate to be hired permanently, I stopped smoking.
Good. Okay, good.
But I was wondering if there's anything I can do to flush my system out quickly. I mean, I've heard of everything from drinking tea
to
drinking
really
vinegar.
Yeah, exercise a lot.
Oh, really? Like sweat it out?
No,
it's in your fat cells,
you mobilize
right?
fat, you'll mobilize some. Lots of fluids. And just give it a couple of weeks. It'll be out. Okay?
Okay.
Provided they don't do a hair analysis.
Oh, I'll tell you, if there's one job where it should be okay for you to smoke pot, it would be a temp worker sitting in some strange office environment in some crappy cubicle answering the phone for someone you hate for 9 hours a day. What could be the problem with him being stoned? I mean, how bad could he go? You know what I'm saying? What's he going to do? Rip off some copier toner or something?
I want to go to the guy who farts.
We are going to that. What? The farts? This is B.O. Samantha.
Oh, but he also farts, too.
What's going on? You're on LoveLine.
Okay, we work in a really close environment, and there's a lot of people where I work, but this one guy, he has really bad body odor, and he will bust ass like he does not care where he is. And I was wondering, is this like a, can you have like a medical problem that results in that?
Now, wait a minute. This guy breaks when?
Whatever he wants. He does not care.
You mean if you're sitting down in a chair and he's like over your cubicle getting some files from up above you, he will plant one?
Yes.
I like the juicy sound effects ones. Those are good.
Do that one again, Mike. All right, easy. Easy. The show is... I'm losing control of the show. Do you notice that, Drew?
Unfortunately, I lost control a long time ago. If you're then losing control, too, we got big problems.
Samantha.
Yes.
You really mean that this guy farts out loud and does not care who is around?
No.
Because I fart at work all the time. But I do... I have
Samantha,
decency.
What's wrong with farting? Farting is fun. Don't you fart?
Yeah.
At work? You fart at work, Samantha. Admit it.
I don't. I mean, I won't.
But that's a form of...
If I'm around friends.
That's a form of on-the-job abuse.
But wait,
it?
What
Seriously.
Do? You just, like, hold it in there and let it burst inside you and cause all kinds of things, like being allergic to cum and stuff like that?
I will go to the bathroom. But he will...
You will go to the bathroom to fart?
Yeah.
You're a lady.
Let me ask Pamela.
I don't go to the bathroom to fart.
Samantha?
Yeah.
I fart in the supermarket,
hey, Pamela,
tonight.
Relax with your farting diatribe for
Come
a second.
Come on, farting is rad. I love to fart.
I know,
Come
but
on.
Let me ask you an honest farting question.
Okay.
Seriously, I want you to answer this.
I'm very honest about my farts.
Yeah, I shouldn't even started it that way. You're on a date with a guy.
Yeah.
You've got some gas going on because you're a little nervous. Nerve gas, we call it.
Nerve gas,
You're back at the apartment.
Uh-huh.
You're with the guy. You excuse yourself to go into the bathroom to mm-hmm. freshen up. Where he's sitting basically a hollow core door that's 1 3/8 away from you in the next room, just sitting there waiting for you to come back on a sofa, continue a little making out.
Mm-hmm.
You have the gas.
Okay.
You have to bust it in
I
the bathroom.
I already got my answer. Go ahead.
Have you ever intentionally spread
yes!
your cheeks?
Yes! I was just going to say that's exactly what you do.
So instead of that...
Yeah, you
sound,
spread your cheeks and it just comes out like air.
You, got,
you get one of those...
Occasionally, it'll be punctuated with the pop at the end. You'll get like
once
one
in a while,
pop.
But you got to make sure to spread them really good.
You'll get...
And you know what the indication is when the sound of your fart changes and you know you're gaining weight in your ass because...
Is that what it is?
Yeah, that's exactly what it is.
Very
it's
interesting.
It's just a flubber.
That is a whole new science you've come up with.
That's exactly what it is.
Measuring,
Julia can't handle
measuring
it.
One's body fat by the pitch of their fart. That you've done the spreader. Oh!
Me and Adam are going to
oh,
get married.
Oh, man. We
come
certainly
on,
are. Dump this guy. We're going to elope. Samantha.
Yes.
So with this, you need to approach this
Samantha,
guy.
Samantha, just bring him a little bottle, you know, some deodorant
no.
or something to work.
No.
And just say, Mr.
No. Intervention.
What?
You need to have an intervention. Do other people in the office feel the way you do?
Yes. Everybody's talked to the supervisor.
Wow. Can you imagine?
Talk to him.
Larry.
This poor bastard just doesn't know. He probably has like that same disease that other guy had. Sounds like some baseball player.
And has the supervisor spoken to him?
He said he would, but he hasn't yet.
Well, it's pretty embarrassing, isn't it, for some supervisor to go over to his
Yeah, you're really earning your money at that point.
The supervisor told me to talk to him, and I was just like, I'd be embarrassed to say something.
Yeah, I'm thinking of seriously having an intervention. What? Where do you work? What kind of job?
It's a information and image management office.
Oh, really? So he's not helping their image.
He's image farting
management. Around the office.
We work with microfiche and microfilm.
Okay. I think what you need to do is one day when he sits down on his chair, duct tape him to it, everyone surround him, and do like they do in those prison movies where you take a pillowcase and you fill it with bars of soap and just start beating him senselessly with it.
I think you should go to like the pleasure chest or something and buy him a butt plug. Bring it to work the next day.
Yeah, that'll be good for about a month, and then there'll be a tremendous explosion.
And I also have another thing to say. Is y'all were talking about female masturbation the other night.
Yeah.
Names for it.
Yes.
Buffing your beaver.
All right. That's okay. We'll put that in the middle category.
What were some of the better ones from the other night?
Paddling the canoe. I came up with shaking hands with Mrs. Paul. There's been a few. Drew knows them, but he's not at liberty to divulge any of those. All right, Drew, you pick a call.
I
want to
pick a call. Let me pick a
call. All right, pick a call, but don't break the monitor.
Okay.
All right, good. You wanted line four. Ryan.
Oh, you're such a bugger.
I got a couple questions about masturbation.
Yes.
First of all, can you, in the shower, can you damage your penis?
Pam, I'm going to throw your ass right out of here if you don't relax.
Boring. Hey, turn on my...
Can you damage...
Thank you, Mike. Go ahead, Ryan.
All right. Can you damage your penis from getting too much soap in the end?
Yes.
In the urethra.
Yes, you can cause some irritation that way.
Burn, baby, burn. Okay.
Urethra is burning.
Burn, baby, burn.
Can't come no more.
What else, Ryan?
Second of all, can you deform your penis from too much?
You can tear it. If it depends what you're talking about, but for the most part, no.
No, it's not like it's clay or something.
But I mean, you can really. I mean,
you could stretch out that skin of lots of wrinkles.
You can fracture it. I mean, you can fracture.
Hey, I shouldn't
go ahead,
say
go
that.
Ahead, go ahead.
I have cracked my penis before. I really have.
There is no bone in the penis, you dodo.
I swear to you, if you would sleep over one night in the morning, it would only, I swear, only in the morning.
Your penis makes early morning sounds?
Only in the morning I can crack it sometimes.
So and you do it with your right hand, I notice. With that gesture.
Actually, I got
to
use both hands.
He's making gestures, good people. I just want to let you know.
There's a ligament.
I'm holding the magazine with
there's
this.
There's a ligament there.
Hey, mister.
There is.
You'll be fine.
So your penis doesn't mold like clay.
No.
Oh, right. God.
No.
It's so I'll be okay.
You'll be
yes,
okay.
Yes.
Thanks a lot.
Yes. It's not one of the California Raisins or Gumby or any claymation characters like that.
I want to hear the person's comment about Adam, what he said about teenagers.
Maria.
Yeah. Okay. I'm 14.
Mm-hmm.
And, I've been through a lot in the last 2 years, and I know for a fact that... I'm capable of making important decisions, and I've had to make a lot of decisions, and especially really important ones.
Like, give us an example.
Well, I don't know, the decisions between, having to deal with my parents, my virginity, being bisexual, the fact that I do drugs, and the fact that I smoke, and the fact that I drink.
Okay, this is exactly what I'm talking about. If you're making a decision to decide to do a lot of drugs, to decide to go against your parents' best advice for you,
that doesn't in
to decide to act out bisexually before you're clear on your sexual identity, you prove my point.
Should I sniff this copier toner or not? Okay, I think I will.
Yeah,
I'm mature enough to make that decision.
I can make that. It's a tough one
I
make.
No, I mean...
Maria, you will look back on these decisions as things that you were not ready to make, decisions that were not made on your best behalf because you were not prepared to make them yet.
But a lot of these decisions I had to be ready to make.
Ah, different issue. Very different. And indeed, that is true, that young people are put in a position where they are required to make decisions that they shouldn't have to make, frankly.
Well,
if
bad
their family
decisions,
were more involved, they had better relationship with their family, they'd have the support there and a network to fall back upon to help them make these decisions and to learn how to make decisions that serve them better, such that when they do completely individuate and move through this period of development, they are making good decisions.
And bad decisions force you to make important decisions down the road, like, hey, I'm not going to use a condom. Do I want to get abortion or not?
Right.
They sort of works that way.
That's right. That's
right?
Yeah.
Right.
All right. Well, I hope you didn't take any offense.
I don't mean to demean or belittle what it is that you're doing in your daily life. Believe me, I have the struggles you have to put up with are already intense enough just dealing with the changes you're going through, the peer pressures, the developmental issues that you're presented with.
All right. Melissa.
Yes.
You're on LoveLine.
Hi. Earlier this evening, a gentleman called asking for some advice because he was having difficulties possibly getting visitation of his unborn child. And I went through a similar situation with my husband. His ex-wife took off with his daughter for about 2 years,
mm-hmm.
and there are some things that you can do. There's a book called How to Do Your Own Divorce in California, and I understand this man wasn't married.
We don't know that he was calling from California either.
Oh, we don't.
No.
Okay. Well, there are...
Well, they should have it for all different places.
Right.
Like, they have New York on $50 a day, Rome on $60 a day.
Right.
Same theory.
A day in a life of...
Right.
They give a lot of it. They give detailed outlines on you need to fill out for legal forms. And if you go down to the local courthouses and you ask for a family law packet, it will have a form in there called an order to show cause.
Hmm.
And if you fill that form out, or if you get a paralegal to fill that form out, and you file it and you serve it on her, then she will be pulled in front of the judge And at that time, they will set visitation and child support amounts.
Okay.
And so that's all you really need to do if you can't afford a lawyer. It's not
great.
That hard.
Okay.
Thank
and
you.
Really important because it is a baby.
Melissa?
Huh?
Is your last name Reno?
No, my last name is
not Reno. All right, just checking. Seem to know a lot about the law. Well, we got about 3 minutes left. Pamela.
Yeah.
You're
it's ironic, isn't it?
No, I was just going to say you've really been behaving for like the last call and a half. I
I've
wanted
been thinking
to give you some positive feedback.
I've been thinking about something else.
Oh, okay.
I'm not going to tell you what it is.
We're anxious about her departure.
We're going to send you in the corner to have some, what the hell's that called? Me time? What's that, quiet time?
Time out.
What the hell is that?
Time out is something I find myself saying about 18 times an hour.
To your kids?
Yes.
Oh,
what
God.
Is timeout?
One of those discipline things.
Timeout is a way.
It's a way of saying neutral. Timeout.
You get that, Mike?
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, we know exactly what All you're right. saying. All right, here we go. Real quick. Jennifer.
Yes, I'm calling because, I'd like to say hello, everybody.
Hi.
Also, I'm calling because my boyfriend and I are having problems in our sexual relationship.
Mm-hmm. Oh, we should be able to answer it between the three of us.
All right.
The three of us and Pamela's four personalities.
I wasn't listening to the question.
Is she a Gemini?
I'm
yes,
a Gemini.
She is.
Are you? Oh, that's great. I am too.
Are you left-handed?
I'm ambidextrous.
Yeah, okay, sweet spirit. Ask the question.
Wait, what's your question?
The question is, how do I get my boyfriend to listen to me when he and I are talking about sex between us? There's not enough foreplay.
How do you get him to listen to you?
Yeah, I keep telling him.
Tie him in a chair, you know?
No, come on, seriously.
No.
The girl wants to know.
Okay. Well, first of all, the way that you phrase your question, how do you get him to listen?
I'll
you tell
you
him. You got to talk. I want to talk to you.
You're an actress. Talk to me. I'll be your
Wait
boyfriend.
A minute. But it's not that he's not listening. It's that he doesn't want to do it.
Well,
he's
yeah.
not changing the behavior.
So I'm
trying to work
so
some
selfish.
Sex here, which you relax
you
through.
I can answer a page.
Adam just wants to have this dialogue with me.
You're
that's
an
all.
Actress. Exactly. All right.
You go have some time out, Dr.
You're
Dude.
Jennifer. What's your boyfriend's name?
His name is Matt.
Matt.
Okay.
All right. I'll be Adam Carolla will be playing the role of Matt.
Okay.
All right.
And
Pamela
what's
Gidley
your name?
Will be
what's
playing the role of Jennifer.
Right.
All right, I'll start. Hey, bitch, get in the bedroom because I need some.
He doesn't call me that. He treats me.
Would you relax? This is theatrics here, for Christ's sake.
Baby, now come on. What's his name? Matt. Matt, why won't you lick my thigh? I know I got some pox on me. come on, baby. You know what? You gotta treat me a little better. You know what I mean? What do you want from
yeah,
me?
Yeah, but you know the part of sex I like. That's that part. And I don't got time for you and your licking and your cuddling and your snuggling.
Well, you know what? I'm allergic to your cum anyway. So get the hell out of here. You're out of here.
Most bizarre thing I've ever heard in my life. That was the worst idea I've ever come up with, Jennifer.
Right, can I get some
Jennifer,
real advice now?
Jennifer,
yes.
Jennifer.
All right.
Jennifer.
I talk to him and I say, hey, you know, I give him plenty of foreplay and he really enjoys it. And I'm like, you know, I need some more foreplay here. When he's ready to go, I'm ready to go too, but I just want more. And he doesn't give anything. I mean, he's just like, you know, let's insert it. Let's go.
Let him know you're serious, Jennifer, and don't let him in until he's clawed at the door for long enough.
Okay.
Do you know what I'm saying?
All right.
All right, we'll be back.
Loveline, we'll be right back when we're damn good and ready.
Mike, did you cue me? Fantastic. Next time I'll look. Well, let me get the phone number out real fast. 1-800-LOVE-191 and the fax number 310-854-4455. This is Loveline. I am Adam Carolla. That is Dr. Drew. He's a board-certified physician. Pamela Gidley was our guest tonight.
Mm-hmm.
She conducted herself like a real lady.
Mm-hmm.
Yelling about poison sperm most of the show. But she is a doll, and if you could see her, you would realize why we tolerated her for over an hour.
Thank you, Adam.
That is a lovely compliment. I thank you for your forthrightness and for dropping your pants.
You're very welcome.
If I can ever drop my pants for you one day, you just say
ask.
The word. We're now going to let Pamela go and bring the boys from Hagfish in.
So Hagfish.
I think we're going from the frying pan into the proverbial fire, but what the hell? It's Thursday. There's 34 minutes of this show left, and we're going for broke. So if you want to see Pamela, if you want to know what I'm talking about, if you want to know why we didn't throw her ass out of here a long time ago, watch Strange Luck. It's on tomorrow night.
Yeah.
It's on Fox.
I don't think I'm in tomorrow night's episode, though.
Oh, seriously?
I don't think so.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Never watch Strange Luck ever again.
That show.
Or just wait for a week and then find Pamela. Pamela, thanks for coming by.
It was a pleasure.
Good luck with your loser rock and roll boyfriend.
He's a swell guy.
You know it's just because I'm jealous. He's a very lucky man.
Okay, and I'm going to make you more jealous.
And we're going to bring in...
I love you, David.
We're going to bring in Tony and Zach from Hagfish. And while they're coming in, we're going to go back to the phones. John. You're on LoveLine.
I had a question for the doc.
Yeah,
he's
John.
Right here.
All right. I have a glaucoma, or I don't know if I have glaucoma, but I might have a 26 and 28 eye pressure.
Right.
And I'm just wondering if you knew anything about, like the laws or anything about that, the recent laws.
About like, what? About glaucoma?
About dry. I hear it's illegal in Nevada.
Well, no, I mean, you know, how you can get high and stuff, you know, because it lowers your eye pressure.
Yeah, that is so, the way you phrase it, John, is so classic, and it's been classic of the experience I've had with people that use marijuana for medicinal purposes, that it definitely needs to be studied more for medicinal purposes. It definitely has some medicinal purposes. But for those things for which it has been suggested to be used, there are many much more effective medications out there, like nausea from chemotherapy,
right?
Like wasting syndrome with AIDS and nausea with AIDS, like glaucoma. That the only people that I have ever seen ask for those medications are, in fact, marijuana addicts.
Right.
And if a marijuana addict is dying of AIDS and wants to have marijuana and it makes them feel better, I don't have a problem with that.
Plus, the suits over at Upjohn don't make a penny off of the marijuana prescription. Yes.
Oh, I'm sure people do. Believe me.
You can grow it yourself. You can have up to 10 plants.
Yeah.
Ready.
Anyway, but for glaucoma in a 22-year-old, it would be totally inappropriate. So don't even think about it, okay?
All right, then. All right.
But as the old Jewish joke goes, it couldn't hoit.
Oh, yes, it could. That's the point. It really could.
Give him an enema. All right, we got Tony and Zach from Hagfish in
here.
How are
you doing?
How's it going?
You guys were chomping at the bit out there for the last hour, waiting for the beautiful Pamela Gidley. Now, give me your take on her. She
doesn't look... I expected a big, tall redhead with a big bust.
Yeah.
I expected, like, sort of a Peg Bundy-looking girl. Because
right.
She has the rough, older... She sounds experienced, you know what
yeah,
I mean?
Yeah, she sounds...
Is she experienced?
Like a merchant marine.
Yeah.
She was giving me bedroom eyes before she left.
Yeah.
And the last call and a half that she was... that she couldn't answer, she was thinking about... While I was making gestures to her over there.
She wanted
to. Oh, yeah.
Bye,
she's
Pam.
Hot. She's hot for
she
you.
She wanted to.
That's just but, what she
yeah,
wants.
Yeah, she did look totally. I expected someone different. Totally.
But quite attractive. Wouldn't you agree?
Well, yeah. You know.
Now, you guys just came. You just had a gig. Was it last night or
last
the night before?
At the Troubadour.
And how'd that go?
It was good. Well, thanks, well. LA. Thanks, Law.
Yeah, did you get a good crowd in there?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
Your wife was there.
Dr. Drew's
wife was there.
They're making
Drew's
out.
Kids, yeah.
Doing a full lesbian thing on the floor.
Yeah. Dr. Drew's daughter's going to have to quit coming out to our show.
She makes three-year-old. The 3-year old?
3-year old.
Look at the doctors. Like, don't go there with that.
She
please.
Makes a nuisance out of herself.
Now, you guys are getting a good local following here in LA.
What do you mean, local? We're not from here.
Oh, you're not?
No.
Kind.
People in LA love you, don't they?
Yeah, he's covering up
your
now.
Wife does.
I certainly am.
No, we're from Dallas.
Oh,
and we got
are.
A good local following in L.A. from Dallas.
Yeah. Where are you bigger, Dallas or L.A.?
We're probably
Dallas.
We're bigger in Dallas.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Why don't you get the hell back to Dallas?
Yeah, we are. Everything's
where
bigger.
Where the Cowboys rule?
You guys Cowboy fans?
No.
Hell no.
Good.
But you know what? Anytime we're in an interview, whatever, last time where were we were some other radio station, and we were going off on how Dallas ruled or whatever, and we didn't even
we'd
care.
We hate football.
And, like, we got all these, hey, man, if you want to take it out in the parking lot of that radio station, then we'll come up there.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, very, very serious.
Actually, it was in San Francisco, and yeah, they were all pissed off about, you know,
and everyone
football.
Has a gun in their car in Texas, too, don't they?
Everybody has a gun, and everything's bigger in Texas. Actually, when we cross the border, my penis actually does get larger.
Oh, really?
Yeah, and I go back. I can, like, step back and forth over the border, and it'll get big and small and big and small.
But your nuts swell, too, so it's a relative thing.
Yeah, I have elephantitis of the nuts, and thank you. Actually, I didn't want to bring that up.
It's funny when
he sits on his stomach.
You've offended me now. I don't even know you.
All right. Now, look. We're going to go to the phones.
No.
You guys are going to behave yourselves. Am
okay,
I right?
Okay, cool. Because what's your name, by the way? I don't even know.
Adam.
Adam, okay.
Would you like an apple?
You ready? Now, Drew, you pick a call.
Any call.
Here we go. Jeremy.
Hey, how's it going?
Hey, you're on LoveLine with Hagfish and Drew.
Cool.
You're on Hagfish with LoveLine. There you go.
All right, here's the craziness, okay? I'm an airborne ranger, all right, with the Army.
Wanna be an airborne ranger.
Yeah, for a long time.
Wait a minute, how long ago? That was quite some years back, wasn't it?
About 3.5, 4.
How old are you?
Almost 22.
Wow.
Okay, so you were young.
Before the drinking age.
Well, basically it was like a week after I got out of basic and ranger school.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it was just like right out. Anyway, ever since I did my first and 3 combat jumps, every time I do like a jump in training now, I totally can't get it up for like a week.
Really?
That is really strange.
That is very strange. It kind of sucks.
Well, I understand you got that big fat black guy going, go! Go! Go!
That's kind of scary. But, I mean, I went to a doctor, and he kind of looked at me stupid-like and said it might be post-traumatic stress.
Right. That's what it sounds like to me.
You know, I mean, I don't know.
I was just about to say that.
Yeah.
No, you weren't.
But
guys in Vietnam got and stuff.
Well, but there's varying degrees of that. I mean, yeah, you can be a mild PTSD, and that sounds
I don't, like, wake up in the middle of the night screaming.
Right, but if you were really in combat or something, you might get a more severe version of it.
And let me tell you, the first thing that goes when you have any kind of emotional trauma is the penis. God's cruel joke.
Isn't there a thing called soft Peter?
Salt Peter.
Or salt Peter.
Salt Peter.
I always
totally different.
See, there we go. I thought it was Soft Peter.
Soft Peter is a self-serve yogurt.
Kind of like that song. What is that song? Blinded by the Light.
Wrapped
up like a douche.
Does it say douche?
Nobody
or
knows.
Douche?
The guy who sings
oh,
it.
Well, let's get
know.
Back to this guy's Peter.
All right.
I mean, it's
getting sidetracked.
It was pretty scary, you know. I mean, I saw combat and almost got hit a couple times. I killed some people.
It was just a normal day.
That's understandable. You
wow,
have
really?
Stress.
No kidding.
Today was a good day.
Now, this was a single time for the week after that particular jump you had problems?
Yeah, it was just, you know, I mean,
who wouldn't have that kind of problem after something
was,
like that? I'm surprised.
It was really scary. And then
John Wayne wouldn't have any problem with that. You see the fighting CBs?
Yeah. I mean, of course.
John Wayne would jump out without a chute.
But of course you're disturbed.
Bounce.
All right. But here, I'm going to answer your question, Jeremy. Here's the deal. You jumped out of the plane. You saw some combat. You had trouble with Cousin Pepe.
Exactly.
Okay. Now,
Cousin Pepe.
You've associated every time you jump out of a plane or even go down a few flights of stairs, you've associated in your mind that you're going to have trouble with Cousin Pepe, right?
I guess so.
So, and let me tell you, the mind controls that part of the body much more strongly than people understand. I mean, that's why when you get people on these mind-altering drugs or even on Prozac or something, boom, they have trouble. So now every time you get in a plane, you go, okay,
exactly.
I'm going to have to take a week off. And you it becomes a self-fulfilling prophecy.
Do you masturbate?
Very regularly.
Okay.
Ask me.
Well, I'll ask you later.
Obviously don't listen to the show.
But you do masturbate.
I got two off before you even got the question.
That's what you're doing over there.
So you do masturbate.
Yeah, but I mean, even after I do a jump, you know, I can't.
Wow.
Oh, you can't?
So
you can't even?
No.
You can't even masturbate?
Nope. You had to do it before you jump.
Wow.
Right? Yeah, that's weird. Salt
Peter. That are like on the way down, but you know, then you get like spray back, and I don't like that idea.
You get what?
you could whack on the way down.
During on a free fall.
You're going to get it caught in your face.
All right, Jeremy.
Well, man, God, that's... Dr. Drew?
It really does sound like a PTSD, and you can talk. There are medications for that. There's talk therapy. There are groups out there for dealing with that sort of thing. Oh, really? I'm sure.
Hey, Jeremy, would it help if your DI came in and went, Tange, hut?
No.
Okay. You can also get a... It's a tube.
I think just... be recognize that it's how you react to the stress, and it's not that terrible reaction, and there much worse reactions can manifest, frankly, and just kind of sit tight and see if they don't just sort of extinguish by themselves.
Quit jumping.
Chris.
Yeah, how's it going?
You're on Love Line with Hagfish.
How's it going?
Hi, man.
How's it going?
It's all right.
All right, well, a couple of buddies and me were sitting around, and we're contemplating the meaning of life as in how do women know when they're done masturbating? Because if you know you're multiply orgasmic, if you're a guy, well, you just know you're done. But if you're a multiply orgasmic,
I can take this.
Can you?
They call their friends, or they call me.
Yeah. No. You know, in my sort of experience,
once
I guess they could just sit there until they get tired. That's when they're done. When they just don't feel like moving their hand anymore.
What, you just get bored, fall asleep, or what?
Hell yeah! I mean, if you could do it, you know. I mean, if eventually, I know it sounds weird, but if you could keep on coming, keep on keeping on. Eventually, it would probably get a little boring and tired, you know?
And it depends what's on TV.
Exactly.
You should call Loveline. 1-800-LOVE-191. Hello, Loveline. Loveline will be right back.
Ziggy Pop, and you're listening to Loveline with Dr. Drew and Adam Carolla.
You know, Iggy wanted to come back tonight, but we said, screw you, Iggy.
Has to be Hagfish.
It's got to be Hagfish. That was the voice.
Plus, he's so baritone, it'd probably crackle the speakers.
This is Iggy Pop.
Actually, Iggy was a very normal and nice and genteel guy. You would have never guessed it.
I kicked his ass once.
Let me get the phone numbers out.
I did.
That? No,
I kicked his ass.
All right. Phone numbers 1-800-LOVE-191. Fax number 310-854-4455. We're here with Tony and Zach from the fabulous Hagfish.
Hello.
And Fabuloso.
We're going back to the phones. John.
Yep.
He hangs up.
John, you're on Loveline.
He's acting like we went.
I got a question regarding. I dated this woman for like 3.5 years.
Bull. What a guy.
Yeah, it's a bummer. Engaged to be married. Yeah, we ended up breaking up. I didn't date anyone for like a year after that. Well, my friend set me up with this woman, and he said that he tells me we're going on the date on Saturday, and he tells me she's really great at giving hummers.
All right.
Yeah. What? So you know, I can't stop thinking about it.
Because he got one from her.
Well, see, that's going to be an issue down the road, but right now I'm kind of concentrating on, you know, just getting one myself.
Yeah, I know, but what, the boys from Hagfish, myself, and possibly even Drew are thinking about that at this point. But the question is he knows firsthand, or from not using his firsthand.
Now, number one, is this guy a really good friend of yours?
Yeah.
Okay, now, what if you really, really like this girl? Say the first date's really good, you really like the girl, and it turns into a relationship, that's going to be in the back of your head that this your best friend has like gotten a hummer from this girl.
In the front of his head, believe
front
me,
of his head. It's going to
the whole relationship.
It's going to mess with you the whole time. I hate guys that my girlfriend has been with before I even met her. I mean, you know, I don't even know him, but I hate him. So this may mess
Mike
with
Tyson.
You. This may mess with you some.
Yeah, John, what do you think?
Well, I think eventually we're probably going to throw over this whole thing, but you need to be my Ben Kenobi here.
How about Chewie?
What's that?
How about Chewie?
I thought it was Obi-Wan Kenobi.
There you go.
We're his only hope.
Yeah. All right. I prefer to think of myself as more of a Yoda-esque character, so I'm going to go ahead and be Yoda. Zach, I'll be Boba Fett.
Can I be Boba Fett?
Who's Boba Fett?
He was Boba Fett. You know, Star
Boba
Wars.
He's green.
Never mind. Okay, listen. This is Star Wars. Tony, I want you to be one of the Ewoks.
Okay.
Why is that?
Because he's
short.
Because he's short.
Look Ewok.
I'm Boba Fett because I kick mucho ass.
Well, you pick Yoda. That's a good one.
All right.
I kick mucho ass.
All right. I can't do that stupid Yoda voice, but go ahead.
I can't do it either.
You be Yoda.
I'm Boba Fett. I can't be Yoda.
No, you be Boba Fett. Okay,
all right. Forget it. Listen. Go out with her.
Uh-huh.
Don't try to, you know, palm the back of her head and ram it into your crotch in the doorway when you pick her up. Actually,
until she gets in the car.
Yeah, wait. First off, your friend could be just goofing on you. I mean, she could be a born-again Christian or a Jehovah's Witness, and he could just be screwing with you.
Ty, do you know for a fact this guy, does this guy hear or did he get one from her?
He says he got one from her.
Well, see, that is going to mess. What if you like this girl? Now, if you just want to go out and get... Have you gotten laid in the last few months or
Wait,
whatever?
Is he wanting to go out with her or something?
Yeah. Well,
oh, really?
You're going out with this Saturday, right?
Yeah.
Okay, have you gotten laid in the last few months?
No, you haven't.
You're calling into Loveline. You haven't gotten laid. So the point is, you're probably going out to get a Hummer, right?
Oh, yeah.
Well, then you're not wanting a girlfriend anyway, then, right?
Have you jumped out of an airplane lately?
Have you seen a grown man naked?
All right. Have you? Hey, John, this is Yoda.
Yoda.
Now, listen. Here's my advice.
The soothsayer, yes.
Yes, listen. First off, don't talk about Star Wars or Star Trek. Because
or Gladiators.
You'll be labeled, or Dungeons and Dragons, because you'll be labeled the big geek that you are.
The guy that got to
John,
school before everybody
listen,
else.
Go out on the date. Treat it like any other date. And just see how the night progresses. And for God's sake, talk up before you leave the house in case anything does actually happen.
Exactly.
Crystal.
Yeah.
You're on Loveline with Hagfish.
Well, before I ask my question, can I find out what a Hummer is?
It's when a girl goes down to you and goes, while she does it.
Is that, like, good to do?
Hell yeah.
I don't know.
No, it's a she's seriously in the dark. It's a blowjob.
Well, I know that it's a blowjob, but she, I'm like, I want to know, like, exactly how to do it.
All you do is go, Zach does it all the time. Zach, how do you do it?
I hum while I do it.
How do you do that without looking stupid?
You look pretty dumb.
You make eye contact.
You look pretty dumb.
His eyes will be rolled up in the back of his head anyway. He'll be staring at his cerebellum at that point.
He's not going to be looking at you.
Yoda, always on time.
Okay, anyway, the reason I called, the girl that called before that was, like, allergic to cum or whatever. Remember that?
She was having some kind of a reaction, possibly, to it.
Yeah. Well, I have had the same reaction. I'm just calling to explain.
Wow. What kind have you had?
There are different reactions that people can get. I mean, some can be from the pH, this acid level in the sperm. Some can actually be a true allergy.
So,
yeah.
Because I've had it checked out. I was going out with a long-term boyfriend like a while back or whatever, and we stopped using the condom together and just started leaving it in. I was on the pill and everything.
Yeah.
And it didn't happen just from one time or whatever.
Right. Like, sometimes it can just be an infection that kind of smolders along, gets rekindled by this. So there's a lot of different things that can happen.
Yeah. And if we would leave it in like a few times, you know, in a short period of time or whatever. Like, it would start to get kind of, like, burny and itchy and kind of, like...
Well, see, I shoot flames out of mine, so...
Sure.
Yeah.
Zach has a problem.
I think I got a problem. Dr. Drew, would you take a look at it in the bathroom later on? All right, good.
Sorry.
But, like, I went to the doctor, and they said that it was something to do with the pH level, like,
right.
Affected the acidity or whatever. And,
right.
I mean, it doesn't, like, really bother me unless, you know, it happens on a regular basis. But
and this girl was having it every time.
He made a flaming cum cocktail.
Oh, that, you know, well, you guys
were
doing
worth a shot.
You're doing so well. And just for that, we have a question for you. Ty.
Hey, Hagfish.
Hey.
What's up? I was wondering if you guys are going to be in Southern California anytime soon again playing shows.
Yeah, we're going to be there tomorrow night.
Tomorrow night?
San Diego. Yeah.
We're coming back through with Everclear at the Roxy for two nights.
When?
March.
March. Yeah.
End of March.
Hey, Ty, don't you have a car?
No, I had to mooch off my friends, and none of the douchebags could go last night.
Well, not when you're labeling them with titles like douchebag.
Hey,
douchebag, can you do me a favor?
Well, yeah, come. We're going to be at the end of March with Everclear, so come out and see that, please.
All right, thanks a lot.
Yeah.
All right, there you go. The one and only Hagfish question. You know, we're going to play a song that you guys have done. One of your crazy little numbers.
One of our crazy little things.
I like
that,
Adam.
That is going to be coming up in a matter of moments, but we're going to get in another call real quick before we do it. Drew's nodding his head to all the calls I've pointed my smelly finger at. You want to smell that?
Ooh, yeah, that's
Robert.
How you doing?
You're on Loveline.
Well, my question is for Dr. Drew.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
I've been wanting to ask somebody about this for years.
Yeah.
What is...
Oh, boy.
Disease you gave me.
Something close. What would happen if you went down on a girl and later on you found out she had a yeast infection?
Probably nothing.
Put jelly on it.
Probably nothing.
Yeah.
Well, I've been sweating over this for years.
Oh, yeah. Do not sweat it.
What
That's
do you mean
sure.
You've been sweating over it for years?
I didn't know. I mean, I thought this. I didn't know if I was just going to take like 10 years off my life.
No, nothing.
What?
Forget it. No.
Anybody doing this.
No.
I was so naive at the time, I didn't question the the taste or anything. So
No, it's going to be... Don't worry about it.
What was
That's
that?
Pretty what disgusting.
That, what was that taste like?
Kind of bitter.
Oh!
You know?
Yeah. And you didn't know anything was up.
At the time, I was just out of high school, to be honest. I didn't know what it was for what it was. I didn't recognize it till some years later. By then, I didn't even know the girl anymore. I couldn't confirm.
Robert, how old are you now?
30.
Robert, wow. This is the most pathetic story I've ever heard. You engage in oral sex when you're in high school. It's been haunting you for the last 13 years.
I'd say you're all right.
I've never heard of such a thing.
Even AIDS wouldn't take that long, really.
All right, Robert.
Yeah.
I'm going to give you something to ponder for the next 13 to 15 years.
Okay.
You ready?
Yeah.
What is the difference between a sofa and a couch?
Ooh.
His head is going to explode at this point.
You just killed someone.
What if C-A-T spelt dog?
All right, relax,
Nietzsche. Hey, yeah, just calm down there.
We've got Plato and Nietzsche over here.
Oh, my God.
Just relax. We're going to play.
Hey, that came from a movie.
All right, we'll review the movie, but first we're going to review your song, Happiness. On LoveLine with Tony and Zach from the famed Hagfish.
That was live. Do you know? Me and Tony just played that here in the studio.
Yeah, it was amazing. Yeah. You guys
Casio
played the drums,
in.
The bass, the electric guitar, the
and
triangle.
Yeah.
Yes. Give me a chance. Yeah. I'm a little sweaty. I'm talking.
Wait a minute, Drew. I don't know. Mike, where are we on time?
We're on time.
All right, we're on time. Here we go. We're going back to the phones. Tricia.
Yes.
What's going on?
Hi, Hagfish.
Hi.
Hi, Trisha.
Trisha.
I'm calling just because regarding the topic that you guys were discussing earlier about the female masturbation.
Mm-hmm.
Just as you guys finished asking that question about how females masturbate, I had just finished having an orgasm by myself. It was wonderful.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, I stop masturbating when I'm tired, and also my clitoris gets sensitive, so, you know, I'm pretty much done.
I hear you, sister.
Anyway,
hey, yeah.
I'd call and comment on that, because I thought it was...
All right, but how many are you usually good for on an average night?
I don't know. You know what? I can't even count them.
Okay.
They just all mesh together. I have a great time.
I have a question, right. Actually.
Yeah.
This is for Dr. Drew. The other night I had sex. Actually, last night I had sex. And, yeah, I did. I swear to God. Yeah, well. Anyway. And after I was done, she swole up and it looked like clown lips.
Down there.
The labia. The labia, right.
Right.
And it went down.
That was unusual. That never happened before.
No, it never happened before.
It was irritated for some reason.
It's blood, though, right?
Yeah.
And let me tell you the male approach.
It was just, you know, swollen.
That's like a...
And pink.
Make your head real big.
You know, my old radio name used to be Dusty Labia. I used to do overnights in Vegas, but that's another story.
Thanks for telling us that.
The deal with men and females in masturbation is when a man is good for one, maybe two, he's got to call the night or a weekend. When a man hears that a woman is multi-orgasmic, the first thing he goes to is, you mean you could sit there and have like 30? And he pictures if he was capable of that, just rattling off 30 in a row in about a half hour.
Filling up a gallon.
But you got to realize a lot of the same rules apply. Women, their things get sore, they get tired, they get sleepy, they get bored. And once you have the big one, anyway, everything's just sort of an aftershock. Right.
Have you ever given a girl the big
a
one?
Dinner mint.
Have you ever given a girl
a girl I've given like a handful of tremors in my life. But
never an earthquake.
No biggies. We'll be back after this.
Hello, this is my dog. His name's Dave. Sit, stay. Roll over. Roll. No, Dave, no.
Loveline will be right back. Stay.
Rocking out, man.
All right, relax. Stop banging
I like
your head.
Heavy metal music.
We have Bad Religion coming on the show Monday.
They'll be able to actually talk to Dr. Drew and like understand what he's talking about.
Actually, one of those guys is my patient.
You're kidding me. No. Well, one of those guys was a professor at UCLA for a long time in paleontology.
Right. No, he was a graduate student.
He's
right.
A genius.
Oh, right.
Yeah.
This guy.
Did I say Sunday?
Greg Graffin. So
you said Monday. It's Sunday.
Oh, I always do that.
You guys
will
be able to talk intellectually. It's going to be a good show.
He's been on a couple times before.
All right. Wow. Are you guys done talking intellectually?
Yeah.
Hey, Adam, I don't believe we were talking to you either.
Because I want to thank Tony and Zach from Hagfish for showing up
you
tonight.
Don't mention it.
You guys, all right, enough touching.
There you go, Jackson.
You guys were on your
best
behavior.
Your hands all sweaty.
I like you.
You guys are clammed up.
You minded your P's and Q's, and we thank you for that. We'd also like to thank Lisa, Lori, beautiful Ann, beautiful Sherry. Yes, I didn't forget Sherry. The ogre, Mike, the engineer. I'd like to thank myself, Adam Carolla. I would like to thank the doc. Well, hell, believe me, if you listen to the show, no one else is going
to
do it. I'd like to thank the doctor.
I'd like
doctor.
To thank you, Adam.
Would you?
We thank you.
I'm picking a nose hair out right now just for you.
We got four seconds left in the show, and you got to go for the nostril.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Dr. Drew, the Hagfish guys, again, Bad Religion, Sunday, and until
Sunday,
then.
Sunday.
Have a good weekend.
So that's it, then.
The opinions expressed on Loveline by Adam Carolla, Dr. Drew, or anyone are not necessarily ours. Be happy.
Be happy. Happy, happy, happy.
I'm happy.
Loveline's producer is Ann Wilkins. Thank you.